Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains. In this video, I'm going to show you how to take a brand new Microtrains gondola. This is a CNO gondola from Microtrains, and I'm going to show you how I weathered it. Now with this, you can take the wheel set off first if you want to, but you got to get the lettering off. And for the lettering, I used 91% rubbing alcohol. But I got to warn you, this is going to take a little while. So, give yourself a little bit of time. The rubbing alcohol will work. You might want to use like an old paintbrush or an old toothbrush to kind of chip away at it. Some people even use like brake fluid. I think that can also take some of the paint off and the decal off. But once you get that off, make sure it's perfectly dry before you start the next step. Now, gondolas take a beating. They're always having their loads shifting around. That's why you'll see a lot of them even warped. They're kind of bowed in the middle. But instead, I'm just going to focus on the top part with this gondola. I didn't want it too smooth and perfect. So I used an old file, and I just kind of took some of the perfect smoothness off the top just by going back and forth with the file. Didn't want to cut away at it too much, but just enough to make it look like it's been banged around a little bit. I also didn't want a black gondola. I wanted it brown, like this one in this picture. So looking through my colors, the one that I thought was pretty close was the Denver and Rio Grande Western Building Brown. You can find something else in your hobby store that's similar, but this is what works best for me. I made sure I didn't cover the whole thing with brown paint. I just used a paintbrush, got a little bit of brown on, and went up and down kind of sloppily, to be honest with you. And that way it still shows some of the black, and the brown is going to be around the edges. The next thing I mixed was the rubbing alcohol with just a little bit of white paint, just a little bit. And then I used that little mixture to highlight some things like on the trucks, a little bit on the underside, and if you look just a little bit underneath that top part. Now for weathering, I always love to use these chalks. I got these years ago, they're still lasting me. I can't even tell you if they make this brand anymore. So if you go to a craft store like Michael's or Pacatan's or maybe just a local craft store, pick yourself up some chalks and get them in three different colors of rust. Get them in some brown, some light grays. And this is what you want to do is use an old paintbrush and just kind of dip it in the chalk and then wipe, kind of dust it on the model. And use a variety because rust will give you different looks. Make each side different because just metal rusts differently. Look at the inside of gondolas. They're a mess. They're not going to be perfect black and smooth. They're going to have a lot of stuff in it. Even when they're empty, they still have stuff in it. So the first thing I did was paint mine brown, and I covered the whole thing with brown, and then I'm going to add all like the debris and stuff on the inside. But before I put the stuff on the inside, I want to seal all this paint, and I want to seal the chalks. So making sure that the paint's dry first, I'm going to use Tester's Dull Coat. That's Tester's Dull Coat. And I'm going to spray the entire model. And what that does is that puts like a seal on it so the chalks don't rub off. And it's going to make the sides a little smoother for applying decals. So spray that whole thing. Spray it outside with good ventilation because that Tester's Dull Coat, it can really give you a sore throat if you breathe that stuff in. It just smells terrible and makes you sick if you breathe it in. Now I decaled my model using Microset and Microsol. Go on YouTube and find some other videos that someone can explain better about decaling. It's not my strength, so I'm not going to go into it too much. But the decal is done. Once it's dry, I sprayed it again with that nasty Dull Coat, and it's ready for the inside. Now my gondolas are going to be multi-purpose. When I say multi-purpose, sometimes these gondolas are used for moving pipe or moving steel coils. And even when they're empty, they're still going to have a lot of wood inside them, usually like 4x4s. So to make the 4x4s, I just got some strip balsa, and I just used my X-Acto blade, and I cut up some small pieces, kind of trying to get as best to scale as I could, and I just have those ready for the next step. Now remember looking inside a gondola, we said there's always a little bit of dirt and debris on the bottom. Well, to make that, I mixed up a mixture of real fine dirt, real sifted good dirt, and limestone ballast, real fine with that. I was kind of stupid. I added some talus, which actually turned out to be a little bit oversized, but maybe you like it, maybe you don't. But yeah, just go with the ballast and the dirt. Then what you want to do is get some CA, super glue, whatever you want to call it, and fill up that whole gondola bottom with a layer of it, a real thin layer. Once again, this stuff stinks, okay? So don't touch it with your fingers. Try not to breathe it in either. But fill that whole bottom of the gondola with the super glue. And then you're going to want to sift in that dirt and limestone mix. Add your wood. Just kind of place things randomly with the wood. And there you go. There's your finished gondola. Now you can go back and really touch up the knuckles or work on the trucks more. That's all up to you. For me, this is what I call good enough. I like it, and it looks really good on my layout. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, ideas, or comments, you guys subscribe to my channel under DJ's Trains. Ask questions. Shoot me an email at djstrains@yahoo.com. Check out my website, djstrains.com. And give me ideas about what to do in future videos. That's why I'm not hitting them out like every week or every 2 weeks, because I'm kind of running low on some ideas. If you want to learn something about the railroad, maybe I can help you out with, send me a message. Thank you guys so much. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Oh, yeah, don't breathe this stuff in.